welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cream cheese potato casserole. And this is a recipe that was sent to me by my friend Lynn on YouTube. And you've heard of her before. I've done several of her recipes and they're all really great. And I needed a potato dish or something of that sort to go with my dinner tonight. And I remembered, I had meant to use this for a long time, but I remembered this for tonight and thought that you would enjoy it. So I'm going to show you how to put together a cream cheese mashed potato casserole. Now I've already beaten one egg over here. So this is in my mixing bowl and it's ready to go. And the first thing I'm adding to it is mashed potatoes. And these come in this form. It's Bob Evans. And you can get a tub like this that weighs 24 ounces. So it's a pound and 8 ounces. And that way you don't have to do your own. But if you want to do your own, that would be fine. Now this is original flavor. They possibly have some other types. I don't normally get this actually, so I'm not that familiar with it. But I know the brand is good. So I'm expecting it to taste very good and to work very well in this casserole. Really, in casseroles, if you need mashed potatoes, sometimes it's worth it to just make instant or buy something like this, because it takes a lot of time to make your mashed potatoes from scratch. If you have a lot of potatoes on hand, of course, you'll want to do that. But just a little suggestion is that if you are short on time, it's really a help to add in something like ready-made potatoes or to use a mix to very quickly make your potatoes. So we're going to be using a mixer on all this in just a minute. The next thing to add is onion. It doesn't have to be this big. Actually, a small onion will do. And I have used the kitchen chopper to get an onion a little bit smaller than this. So I probably don't need all of that in there. So I'm just going to rake out part of it. Small onions worth chopped. I'd say about like that. Should be fine. And then next comes our cream cheese. I have fat-free variety of cream cheese. And you need 3 ounces. And if you'll have it at room temperature, it's going to blend in so much better. So let's put our 3 ounces, excuse me, of cream cheese in. And then a couple more things. I need 1 tablespoon of flour. This is all-purpose flour. So that goes in. And I need to season it up with salt and pepper. So I'm just going to use my shakers here and just do this to taste. If you don't use salt very much, then you can go light on the salt. And if you don't like pepper in there, you can leave it out. But it's very nice if you do season it up at this point with a little bit of salt and pepper. Now what I want to do is use my mixer to get this nice and smooth. And I have a casserole dish that's prepared and waiting for it. You can see it right here. So I think it's about the right size. Let's blend this, and when I come back, it'll be in there. Here is our casserole of cream cheese mashed potatoes ready to go into the oven. So it's going into a 325 degree oven, and it will bake for about 30 minutes. Now, right before it's done, maybe 10 minutes or so before the end of baking, I will be putting some sort of topping on here. So you don't want to miss that. So I'll see you back for the topping. Our cream cheese potato casserole has been baking in the oven for 20 minutes, and here's what it looks like, and we're ready for the topping. Now, I got French's brand of French fried onions. Lynn actually said to use Durkee brand, or Durkee's, I don't know which one it is, but I didn't have those on hand, so I'm just going to use these, but I would advise you to use what she said, Durkee's brand. Put those on the top here, and she said in her email to me that this is really what makes it luscious. When you bake these in, we're just going to put it in the oven for another few minutes, then that gets distributed when you scoop out some. You get a taste of the onion along with the potato and the cream cheese and onions and everything, and it's just wonderful. So let's give it another 10 minutes or so. We don't want to burn these, but it does go back to the oven at 325 degrees. This is the finished cream cheese potato casserole that Lynn provided the recipe for, and it looks wonderful. It's going to really go well with our dinner tonight, and I want to say thank you to my good friend Lynn on YouTube and Facebook. My viewers are really enjoying the recipes that you sent me, and I hope to get more. Thanks a lot, Lynn.